But Newton, again, a great mathematician, began to see how this stuff was organized lawfully. So Newton's world is this kind of an overseeing God who sees a world of orderly stuff, law and order, the world as a machine. And we began to operate like this. You know, I often tell people, well, I take the common example of church on Sunday. You know, wherever you go to church, where I go to church, everyone sits in the same pew. That's Newton's world. We're sort of like mechanically wired this way. So I came into church one Sunday and I was a little bit late and I thought, there's someone in my pew. Now, no one ever said this is Ilya's pew, but we think like this, and therefore, when that happens, our whole being is sort of upturned. We can't even go to Mass anymore because now we have to go look for a seat, and it's not the same seat, right? We know in religious life the same thing. Keep the rule will keep you. You know, follow the law, and you'll be okay. It doesn't matter what you do, just follow the law. And so we began to, I think, build a world like this, a world according to Newtonian principles. And in some ways, I think this is why our systems, you know, across the board are not working anymore, because this paradigm is, in a sense, giving way to something new. Barbara Taylor Brown says, we started operating our churches like Newton's world. She says, walk into many churches and you'll hear God described as a being who behaves almost as predictably as Newton's universe. Say you believe in God, you'll be saved. Sin against God, you'll be condemned. Say you're sorry, you'll be blessed. Obey the law, you know, you'll be blessed. Sorry, you're forgiven. So people always ask, I pray, why do bad things happen to me? Right? Newton's God has failed me. Here's what I think has happened in our own day. Our cosmology no longer fits with our theology, and we are no longer the center of this wonderful cosmos. And I think we have been displaced and we have become lost in space. And here we are, falling off the earth. Théo Desjardins, who is, in a sense, a guiding figure, a major guiding figure for my own work, a wonderful Jesuit paleontologist, very insightful, I would say a mystic in his own right, noted that the artificial separation between humans and cosmos is at the root of our contemporary moral confusion. We don't know how to act anymore because we no longer know how to read the stars.